Upon a time, Walrix was the most dangerous warlock in the land. We'll have to see if he can return to his former glory on Diabolus. Nixie, Azeroth can be backing him up. This roguelock druid setup is something we haven't seen in quite some time, but it was popular early in the spring season. We'll have to see what they can get done. Mercy and Jamie on the Elemental Shaman and Destruction Warlock will be able to shut him down quite a bit, but with the backup of Nixie, the Kidney Shot, that might allow Walrus some moments of opportunity to actually land those big, significant Chaos Bolts where they can get really aggressive.
I am interested to see how this matchup plays out. This is the first time we're really going to see Rogue Warlock against Elemental Shaman Warlock. Both Warlocks have their Infernals rolling, so their damage is going to be amplified for the next couple of seconds. Let's see who can avoid the big hits, who ends up making a mistake. Nixie being blasted down. Trinket Cloak of Shadows immediately respecting Mercy's assault. This is very interesting to see kind of like an old king, Walrix, on that Warlock. He's been a Titan for so many years. And now in game number one, Mercy, the newcomer Warlock, has an opportunity to overthrow the reigning king. Will he be able to? So far, the momentum is looking like it's in their favor.
Yeah, Walrix around 50% health. Azeroth should be able to keep him topped off at this moment of the game, but he's caught into a full fear. There's no Tremor Totem to back him up. Now Walrix is in an unfortunate situation, in a mortal coil. Mercy's just kind of having his way with Walrix at this point in the game. You can see Azeroth, his mana's not doing great either. Right now, Diabolus is behind in basically all regards. Walrix getting low, could be his unending resolve. Full blind on Drainer, Heat Trinkets out, and Walrix almost gets bursted down. Still greedily not using that unending resolve. Ironbark comes in, does keep him alive, but he got down to 5% health. That could have easily just been a killing blow with a bit more damage.
Yeah, Drainer is munching on Walrix right now in cat form, adding a bunch of extra damage to the team and almost found a kill there. So the Feral Affinity definitely paying off. Azeroth, his mana is not looking good. Defense isn't looking good either. Drainer is finally being punished for this aggressive stance, getting stunned up when he jumped in to start attacking Walrix, although no real damage. Drainer with the disrespect, just slapping around Walrix in midfield, even as the healer, and Diabolus struggled to get a footing.
Yeah, Diabolus definitely having a hard time right now. Enervate is up for Azeroth. Does manage to top off his team, but he needs to find a moment of opportunity to sit down, get a drink, recover his mana. If he can do that, Diabolus won't be in a horrible position, but pressure in favor of Zizon for most of this game.
Pressure in favor of Zizon, certainly. There could be opportunity to punish Drainer for his aggressive stance, and that appears to be the line that Diabolus are trying to take. Chaos Bolts flying in for Mercy onto Nixie. Lightning Lasso, big combo, 4 seconds away from Cloak of Shadows. But it is going to come off cooldown. Nixie will survive. And then they switch their attention to Walrix. Mercy's pressure much higher, which is a little bit not anticipated. As both Warlocks are being left open, you would have thought that Walrix would take the upper hand. But I will say that Drainer's Feral Affinity usage, this extra damage, is really the difference between Zizon and Diabolus in terms of output. I mean, look at this pressure. Walrix is never topped off. Azeroth consistently expending mana to just stay alive. He needs to drink, but Drainer could go in cat form and go for the kill at this moment. Can they stop the drink and also go for the kill is the question. Looks like they're not able to. I see an Infernal walking its way away from where Azeroth was. How much mana did he get? If he goes back to full, that certainly keeps them in the game.
Yeah, he's going to be near full mana at this point. Walrix, though, caught in the open in a bash. A lot of incoming damage from Jamie and Mercy. His Walrix is going to be able to survive. Azeroth, he's got a few moments left on that Ironbark. Nether Ward buys him those moments he needs. Kitty Shot now over on Jamie. And now, Diabolus, they've actually swinged the momentum in their favor with that drink. Now it's Drainer that has to sneak away. Walrix is getting low. Do they have the damage to take him down? Through Ironbark, it is unlikely. Mercy just throwing out fears after fear, getting Walrix out of that efflorescence, that additional healing, but he does manage to find his way back in. Jamie with a nice lightning lasso, getting some additional damage out. Big swap over onto Drainer, and I think Diabolus, they need to be focusing on this. Drainer is putting out way too much damage with that Feral Affinity cat form. When he's in the open, Walrix, he needs to be turning his attention to Drainer. Nixie has to back him up with those kidney shots, and if they can pressure Drainer away, that will be an opportunity for them to try to find some pressure in this match.
Their main advantage is that the Assassination Rogue brings the Mortal Strike effect, which reduces all healing on the targets applied with Wound Poison, which he can put on all three players at the same time. So at a certain point in this game in Dampening, I could see that definitely working out for Diabolus, but the weakness that the Rogue brings is that he's a melee DPS. He has to get up close and personal, and when fighting two casters, such as the Elemental Shaman and the Warlock, it means that you're always going to be fighting where Zizon wants to fight, which means you're going to be most vulnerable. So Nixie needs to maintain his health, try and have the wound poison on as many targets as possible, and look to ramp up pressure deep into Dampening, as Dampening has just started. Azgrath needs to try and drink while Nixie focuses on staying alive. How much mana will he get here? Not too much, but at least evening the ball game, although I think he needs to have a lead on mana. Drainer hasn't drank once, and he's at the same amount, so significant pressure difference between the teams already.
Yeah, definitely Jamie in a little bit of trouble. He's trying to get behind the pillar out of line of sight, and that's one of the advantages Jamie has, is he can just run away from Walrus at any point he wants, and that really limits their damage output. But Nixie on the Assassination Rogue just brings so much consistent pressure, plus that Mortal Wounds. Nice setup here from Diabolus. Jamie getting low, needs to try to avoid some damage. Astral Shift comes in. Nice Vanish Garrote Silence on a Drainer. What is Drainer going to do? Iron Bark gets overlapped with the Astral Shift. Jamie gets topped off, but that was a nice push by Diabolus, and they did manage to get essentially every single defensive cooldown Zizon has available.
Good push there from Diabolus, and opening for Walrix now to set up for the win with Dark Soul and Infernals available shortly. Although he is being pressured by the Lightning Lasso as well as the Feral Affinity, Drainer's trying to be deflected, but Mercy protects him with the double Mortal Coil, launching a couple Chaos Bolts out as well. Asgrass mana is not looking good whatsoever. Pressure is building onto Walrix. Drainer is just so bold in the matchup. He's in cat form more than he is out of cat form. Infernals landed for Mercy. They're looking to close. Any big hits here, any sort of wavering in defense, and Walrix will fall. He's interrupted, unable to use Unending Resolve while interrupted. Where's the damage? Can they push him over? Drainer jumps in, interrupted again into a Lightning Lasso. Big damage, nice Nether Ward, reflecting Mercy's Chaos Bolt back at him. Mercy looking for crowd control to end the game. Walrix on the run, but Mercy and Drainer are hunting him down. Jamie's making his way over. Iron Bark available, but there's no mana. Infernals are coming in for Walrix. It's do or die. Walrix needs to get a kill with these. If he doesn't, I think he's going to be overwhelmed.
Yeah, Walrix in a lot of trouble. Azeroth does throw out the Iron Bark to keep him alive. He has the Unending Resolve, but can't be too greedy with it. Jamie has a lot of damage at his disposal. Walrix getting low, 20% health. Nixie trying to play a little bit of defense by pressuring down Drainer, but I don't know if Walrix can survive. Lightning Lasso coming in from Jamie, a huge hit. It is going to be the Unending Resolve to keep Walrix alive. He's caught into a Fear Mercy denying him, but it's Drainer that has to play defensive. He's in a lot of trouble. He's already used Barkskin. He's used his Trinket. He's incredibly vulnerable. Walrix still low. Azeroth sitting down for a drink. If he can recover his mana, this is great for Diabolus.
He's not going to be able to. There's no defense. He's in a Fear. He Trinkets into another Fear. Mercy with beautiful crowd control. Defensive smoke bomb, but they're on top of Walrix. It's going to provide no defense. Walrix becomes overwhelmed, and I would say that game was BC in the first Summer Cup, and now looking to do the same here in Summer Cup number two. Zizon definitely leveling up in terms of their skills and capabilities, and now with Change My Mind out of the tournament in 7th, 8th place, it's an opportunity for Zizon to surpass them on points, potentially snag a spot at the Summer Finals, where they can then fight to qualify directly to BlizzCon and the World Finals. So this is the opportunity that both these teams effectively have been waiting for. Which one's going to take it? So far, I feel like momentum has been in favor of Zizon. I'm curious to see if Azgrath is running that Feral Affinity. Drainer appears to be. Drainer just loves being... I almost think he wants to play Feral and not Resto at this point.
I mean, he's been able to get really, really aggressive, and those talent choices definitely give his team a nice little edge, especially if he can get that damage off. Nixie getting a kidney shot over onto Jamie, starting to develop some pressure. And we kind of talked about the Assassination Rogue, and we've been talking about them. Their consistent damage in a matchup like this starts really adding up over time, especially as you move forward into Dampening. They bring the Mortal Wounds with the Wound Poison and very heavy consistent damage with all the bleed and poison effects that they have. For an Elemental Shaman like Jamie, this spells disaster. Early on, I'd have to say I would give the edge to Zizon, but if Diabolus can bring the game late enough and they can keep up the pressure over onto Jamie, it's definitely a matchup that favors them in the late game.
All right, can Zizon maintain their defensive posture long enough to overwhelm the opposing team? The Warlock, Druid, Shaman, a composition known for Dampening, I would say is the original Dampening composition. Although in this position, they're getting a ton of burst damage, maybe even an Ice Block. Big heal from Azgrath right at the last second. Allows Alec to get aggressive, secure a Ring of Frost on a Drainer. Jamie uses his Grounding Totem to stop one Gladiator's Maledict. Doesn't have it, obviously, for the second, so he's going to be under a bit of pressure. Uses a cap totem to stop crowd control. Beautifully done by Jamie there, disrupting the absorption effect, breaking up the crowd control, and now enabling Drainer to get out some extra damage onto Alec and continue pressuring. Lightning Lasso on Alec. Nixie is unable to interrupt. He's too far away. He's actually trying to potentially attack Drainer, stunning him up in cat form. Frozen Orb gets dropped, but Alec is interrupted. He's trying to go for Burst, but they're getting peeled away and denied on the swap onto Drainer. Overall, I will say Zizon do a great job of allowing Drainer to play so aggressively, and if they can allow Drainer to play aggressively, then they're going to have effectively three damage dealers on their team, and I do like the way that they play around him so far.
Nixie's going to be continuing up the pressure over on Jamie. If you look at mana, Azeroth at around 65% right now. Drainer caught into a Cyclone, so we can't see his mana just yet, but I'm curious to see who has the lead at this point, and it'll sort of be the story of who has to sneak away and go for those drinks. The team that does normally loses a little bit of pressure and has to play a little bit more defensive, so we'll have to see how that plays out. Obviously, we can see now Drainer way ahead on mana at around 90%. Getting bursted down with a nice swap coming in from Alec and Nixie, getting some nice consistent damage off. Drainer playing really aggressive like we talked about with that Feral Affinity, but that opens him up and leaves him susceptible to swaps and sort of rushdown strategies like we could see coming out from Alec and Nixie.
I think it's a bait. I don't think Drainer is actually going to die, and they're just attacking him, and then the Destruction Warlock is free casting. Elemental Shaman is free casting. I mean, every kidney shot's going on Drainer, which means Mercy is never stunned and Jamie is never stunned. And as long as they can protect Drainer and he's either at a has Demonic Gateway to escape or has a Barkskin, outside of Vendetta, I don't think they're going to kill Drainer unless Azgrath as well is running the Feral Affinity. But so far, we haven't seen much Feral Affinity from him, especially in this game where it matters the most. He is looking like he wants to sneak away, drink, and regenerate mana. Drainer's trying to stop him by jumping over. Nixie commits the Vanish to prevent Drainer from stopping the drink. How much mana did Azgrath get? Not nearly enough. Drainer is now out of the Ring of Frost. Is that an Imp to spell onto Drainer's Ring of Frost? I'm trying to pay attention. The Imp is so difficult to actually see. I don't see
it
a spell. It ended up breaking just to damage. This is very unfortunate for Diabolus. Zizon is just walking all over them. I mean, the way they're playing this Elemental Shaman Warlock Druid, the way Drainer is playing it in particular, just hyper-aggressive in their face, attacking everyone. And you feel like, well, what is this Resto Druid doing? Like, we should just attack him and kill him. But if you do that, then you're just left with an Elemental Shaman and a Warlock free casting, destroying your entire team. And if you don't kill him while you're attacking him, then you have three members owning your entire squad. So the aggressive Warlock Shaman Druid strategy looks like it's working so well.
Yeah, Drainer just sat through a blind into a sap, into a polymorph, into a bash, and Diabolus couldn't find the damage they needed to force out a single defensive cooldown. That is kind of a disaster in this situation. They wanted to at least force the trigger from Drainer or the Astral Shift from Jamie, but they got nothing. Zizon did not give them an inch in this matchup. Diabolus does manage to sneak away. Azeroth, off the back of that pressure and crowd control, does manage to get away and go for a drink, and he could completely reset his mana just as dampening hits, and that's going to keep Diabolus in this game. That was a very important moment. Although they weren't able to force out any defenses from Zizon, it made them position in a very defensive manner, which allowed Azeroth to escape and go for those drinks.
All right, Azeroth getting swapped to by Zizon. He regenerated full mana, but he doesn't have full health. And if that hits zero, then you just lose. He has to trade significant defensive cooldowns to survive that swap. Now Alec left behind. Zizon immediately switching their attention, spreading their damage out. Drainer's moving in again. He gets bashed. Alec gets disrupted by the Earth Elemental stun of Jamie. They're doing a great job of shutting down all attempts at Drainer, whether it be crowd control or kills. Now he's spending a lot of extra time in cat form. Potentially Azgrath should be looking for more hibernates to try and force Drainer away into crowd control. You haven't seen any hibernate poly combos casted while Drainer's been standing in their face. I think that's probably the better way of dealing with this than going after him. Then focus down the Elemental Shaman when you get control onto Drainer, because right now Drainer is just having too much fun.
Yeah, Drainer, he's been able to get a lot of work done in that Feral form so far in this matchup, doing a lot of damage onto Alec, onto Nixie, onto Azeroth during those moments of opportunity. Drainer now getting aggressive over onto Alec with the bash, helping out his team, locking Alec down. Azeroth goes for a restyle, bounds the pounce onto Mercy, but they haven't been able to pressure down Drainer, and that really is the story of the game. Like you said, Sid, if they go after Drainer, they commit the kidney shots there, then all of a sudden you have a free casting Mercy on the Destruction Warlock, a free casting Elemental Shaman, and it becomes very dangerous really quickly in this matchup. Another setup you can see here onto Jamie with the bash over on Drainer. He doesn't have his trinket. Now, I think that's actually... Did he trinket out of the
blind? Trinketed blind.
Okay.
But I think that was set up by Diabolus. They have Icy Veins and Vendetta, so Drainer is, that is a situation where he will die if he's not saved, even through Barkskin. If he's stunned in cat form with those two powerful cooldowns activated, he won't make it out alive on his own. He uses Iron Bark preemptively. This is so he can actually just jump on top of Diabolus and maybe just outright overwhelm them, but he is spending a lot of time basically bad mannering because Vendetta and Icy Veins are big hitting spells. If he gets caught, and he does get caught, they pop Vendetta immediately. Mercy is trying to save him with double Mortal Coil and Fear. Mercy with perfect peels, but Drainer actually jumps right back into Nyxie's clutches, stunned up, but he is at the Demonic Gateway. He can use it if he needs to. I think he has to. There's not much defense, but Azgrath is actually waiting at the other side of the gateway. He's trying to drink and also prevent Drainer's escape at the same time. Azgrath goes into stealth, moves away, and dodges the Thunderstorm. He's crossing away, looking if he can drink on the other side of the map, maybe. He stuns Mercy. He doesn't go for crowd control. Big damage on Alec. Azgrath spent a lot of time just trying to avoid combat and potentially drink, and all that time he spent in stealth now cost Alec an ice block.
Malak forced into the ice block. He does manage to get out of it. Azgrath tops him off quite quickly, but he doesn't have much mana left to work with. We're at 20% dampening. Things might start spiraling out of control here for Diabolus. Zizon has just had control of this matchup from start to finish. Azgrath gets caught into a fear. Alec could be in a little bit of trouble here, but he's positioned at the pillar quite nicely. Mercy just getting polymorphed up. Now a nice little setup going out onto Jamie. Diabolus might be able to start getting some damage rolling. This is the Icy Veins coming in from Alec, but quite frankly, they're not really able to get too much done. There's a full polymorph on Drainer. This is exactly what they needed. Ray of Frost being channeled out onto Jamie. Nyxie all over him. And this, on a moment's notice, Davos could turn this matchup in their favor. An Assassination Rogue in Dampening is really scary for these Elemental Shamans to deal with.
I think Hibernate Polymorph on Drainer is the best way to deal with him in Feral Affinity chasing you down and then go after Jamie with all of your pressure. I think that's much better strategy than what we've seen so far. Alec in a bit of trouble. Azgrath activates Innervate to get some free heals. If he gets dispelled on that Innervate, he will not get the free healing. Jamie not able to remove it. Innervate gets to be benefited there on the Overgrowth as well. It's the most expensive heal a Druid has. You definitely want to make sure you get that ability off. While Innervate is active, Alec and Nyxie both consistently pressured away. Although with that big push onto Jamie earlier, I think that it is anyone's match. Nyxie overextends chasing Jamie. He's now stunned up. Mercy could move in for a game-winning Fear, potentially. They knock Nyxie in midfield. Mercy roots him out in midfield with Conflagrate and then Fears him off. Good teamwork there between Jamie and Mercy. Now double Mortal Coiled. Azgrath's going to have to spend a lot of mana to heal both Alec and Nyxie as they spend some time in midfield. Azgrath crosses the map as well. Diabolus are in full retreat, looking for an opportunity with this next Vendetta. Potentially a swap on Drainer, but Nyxie got left behind. He's bashed. I don't think Tranquility is going to be enough at this point in Dampening. Lightning Lasso, huge attack. That War Stomp again.
Oh, nice.
Another game-winning War Stomp from Drainer.
Attacks onto him, and, you know, entire squad of Zizon really has been performing well so far. We'll see if it's going to be a hot 3-0. Take it away, gentlemen.
I will say Zizon is looking hungrier than any other team in the tournament to qualify, almost more hungrier than I was with that opening cutscene with those delicious snacks sitting on the tables.
They keep doing that to us,
don't they? Like it's a bit unfair because I mean, do the ghosts actually eat the food, or does the food just
why are they making right through them? I think
us here at the AWC would like to invite you to a dinner party to watch Diabolus and Zizon go head to head, which could be the potential final game of this series. Zizon just one game away from closing it out. Diabolus basically with their backs against the wall. They have to win this game or they will be knocked down to the lower bracket, and you do not want to be in that position. So far, those teams are looking like they are very devastating, dangerous squads to go up against. Alec taking a little bit of damage early on. Mercy relays his gateway, so he's going to be positioning right outside of this room that Alec and Azgrath have sort of taken as a defensive position. There's been decent pressure onto Jamie so far. Growth Silence into Cheap Shot, a nice standard setup coming in from Diabolus to get the sap over onto Drainer, but Drainer's just been so greedy, sitting through these blinds and saps, and not really forced to use any sort of defensives.
Yeah, good crowd control attempt by Diabolus, but no damage to back it up. And I think this is where the playstyle difference comes in, because Zizon have said that some rogue mages just smack them around and then other ones, they have an easy time. And I think it's the rogue mages that focus on overly defensive play that Zizon are able to defeat. And I mean, speaking honestly, Alec is probably the most dampening mage in the game. That's why he won BlizzCon, was because he focused on just dragging on every single game as long as possible. And sure, it's a skill set that is attributed to him, but when facing a composition like this, the Elemental Shaman, the Warlock, and the Feral Affinity Druid, it's easily exploited. And I think that is why we see Zizon so confidently I mean, smashing Diabolus.
I mean, that could be the case. Drainer caught into a stun. Jamie taking a little bit of damage. He's going to be trading out that Astral Shift. They're getting aggressive on Alec. That was a big Earth Shock incoming from Jamie, partnered with a Chaos Ball from Mercy. And these are the moments in the game that are just really scary to deal with. Another Sap over on Drainer out of the, I believe that was the Blind. He trinkets out into a Polymorph, and now finally in some crowd control. And Diabolus manages to get Drainer's Trinket out of the way. Full Kidney Shot onto Jamie. He does manage to get into Ghost Wolf, so he's going to be able to survive that setup. And now, as Zizon can reverse the pressure over onto Alec, but he's playing very defensive, using the center pillar to just avoid as much damage as possible. There is an opportunity here for Diabolus to go after Drainer if he plays a little bit too aggressive, but they haven't fully been able to punish him so far in the series.
2017 BlizzCon champions Nixie, Alec, and Azgrath are having a hard time here against Zizon. Jamie, a former team member, kicked off and now looking to take down his former team. Drainer, formerly part of the Pumpers with Cervantes, looks like he's had to remake his roster as well, along with Nerdrage. And a new pickup, the Warlock Mercy. This team looking like a strong contender in the European region, the only team in between both Europe and North America to be running this Warlock Shaman Druid composition at this level with these specific strategies. And perhaps we see teams like the Boys, who have this composition available, if they're watching, stealing some of these strategies to use in the North American region, because we have seen regions take each other's strategies and adapt them for their own uses when they start hitting a wall in terms of compositions. And it's interesting how each region levels up based on the fact that the compositions were so different from each region to begin with. Now they're so wide and varied. Jamie cycloned at low health. Drainer's Iron Bark is denied. Jamie in a lot of trouble. Diabolus finally with some momentum here in the matchup, but they're on match point. Azgrath jumps in. Bit surprised not to see him stun Jamie, stunning Mercy instead. Then moving over to Cyclone Drainer. Beautiful crowd control here by Diabolus that gets them the Astral Shift before Vendetta. So there's a big opportunity right now for Nixie on the next Kidney Shot to overwhelm Jamie. Jamie needs to be ready for it. Zizon need to prepare to protect Jamie. If they can keep him alive during that moment, then almost certainly they're going to continue to overwhelm Diabolus. But if they can't keep him alive, then they're going to be losing this game, and Diabolus will have an opportunity to come back in the series.
Yeah, Azeroth into a bash. He is forced to use the Bark Skin as they make an attempt on him. He just wants to limit all that incoming damage. Infernals get dropped out. Big attempt here by Zizon. Mercy wants to get hyper-aggressive. Double Mortal Coil onto Alec, onto Nixie. What is he going to be able to get done? Big Chaos Bolt incoming. Immediate Ice Block by Alec. He is not messing around. That would have been a huge Chaos Bolt that could have easily closed out the game. This is Mercy's opportunity to really get some damage rolling, and they get big defensive cooldowns because of it.
All right, Kidney Shot attempt on Jamie. That was a bait. Nixie was hoping that Drainer would use Iron Bark and then have an opening with the Vendetta, but Drainer didn't fall for the bait. Drainer's having some fun time right now in cat form, freely attacking whoever he wants. Zizon just pushing Diabolus around. There was an opening, but it's slowly being lost here. 15 seconds away on Jamie's Astral Shift, tossing out the Elementals to chase down Azgarath. I say that I like Jamie's management of these Elementals, just using them to keep the enemy healer in combat. That is the main strategy of the meta in 8.1, is revolving around mana retention and getting drinks. So sending your pets, rather than focusing on them to do damage to your target, sending your pets at the enemy healers to keep them in combat is usually the best strategy. They are trying to employ that here against Diabolus. However, Azgarath has managed to slip away. Mercy is polymorphed, unable to stop. Drainer is stunned, unable to stop. Diabolus play goalie perfectly here to get a drink, but they have to exchange an ice block, and now Alec is unlikely to see another for the match, so they will have mana to keep the fight going. But now Azgrath's Glider's Medallion has been burned on a fear. If Azgrath is crowd controlled and there's enough burst damage, Alec will have no defense and likely die. So a necessary but risky exchange on the part of Diabolus, as they are on match points.
Yeah, Alec gonna be in a lot of trouble. There's no trinket on Azgrath, no ice blocks for another 4 minutes. Dampening's at 8%. Zizon has a perfect opportunity to take someone down in this matchup, but you can see Nixie, he's got every single one of his cooldowns. He can be the playmaker for his team in this matchup. Drainer has got no trinket. They might be able to go after him. There's going to be an opportunity with Vendetta, with Icy Veins, Diabolus. They could all in Drainer, or they could go the safe route, try to just go after Jamie, get the crowd control on Drainer, and I think that's a lot safer and potentially the better option in this matchup. Jamie in a little bit of trouble right now as Vendetta gets pulled out by Nixie. They're looking to get aggressive. Astral Shift gets used by Jamie. Is there any follow-up? Banished Sap coming in from Nixie, setting up his team quite nicely to potentially get a kill. 10% dampening. You cannot mess around against a Rogue Mage Druid. Drainer trades out the Iron Bark, but that's basically all the defensive. Big hit on Azeroth! He gets taken down. That was a beautiful setup. Mercy, what an excellent job.
Feed versus the fake Zebras. We're all tied up 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered in the middle of history the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.